16 Pro Max. Let's have a look. I got it in black. There it is. So this is the paperwork now. That's it. No more stickers. I wonder if the old cases work. Don't do this microwave case anymore. Put the new phone into the old case. Doesn't quite fit, look at that. The new one is slightly taller. Width is the same. Actually, it's funny because that looks blue on there too, doesn't it? Huh. So I thought it was a problem with the iPhone showing the wrong colors, but this is actually a black case and it looks blue on my DJI Pocket as well. How does it look on the Sony? All right, let's do setup. So we're gonna go to the quick start. Now it's looking for a nearby device, so I'm gonna bring my other iPhone, my old one. And so you want it so you can do your Face ID so it can see you. Now it's connecting. There we go. So we're gonna take this one and we scan it, sees that code. Make sure it's connected to Wi-Fi, of course. Set up the new phone. Set it up for me, please. I'm not gonna show you my other passcode. Here we go. Yep, double click to confirm. Now it's transferring my number from the old phone to the new phone. I can see it still says SOS, which means that the number's not activated on there yet. This is assuming you have a carrier. My carrier is AT&T. Looks like it's working, it's there. So now it's activating the eSIM. So we're gonna turn that on, continue. It's activated, I see there is now a carrier on there. So this is now my phone, my number is on there. Okay, so now we have to transfer our data and apps. So we can do it from an iCloud backup, from another iPhone, from a Mac or PC on Android. What I'm gonna do is I'm actually gonna do it from an iCloud backup. Now I did a backup last night, so I haven't really done anything on the phone since I backed it up. If you haven't done a recent backup, back up your phone first. So if you go under the settings, go to iCloud here, and then you'll see the iCloud option, and you see iCloud backup, click on there, and then you'll see the option to backup now. So make sure you back that up first, and then we can restore. This is the fastest way to do it, is to restore this from that. The downside of doing it this way is you do have to log into all your apps again. Now it's gonna ask me which backup I wanna use. It's looking for them right now. Obviously I'm gonna do the one I did last night, the most recent one. And there's the options to make this my new phone. So now it's restoring for iCloud. So what'll happen is this will get all my data and everything from my iCloud account, put that on there. And in a few minutes, I'm gonna be able to start using the phone. And it's gonna continue to download the apps in the background. And that can take a while depending on how fast your internet is. But this way is definitely a faster way to get your phone up and running than transferring it from phone to phone. However, you can connect a cable between the phones to speed that up a little bit. And there's another option where you can connect it to your Mac and download it from your Mac, which is a couple more steps, but if you do it that way, you don't have to actually sign into all your accounts again or all your apps again. So that's my unboxing and setup. Let me know in the comments underneath if you're getting a new iPhone or which phone you currently use, what's your favorite phone right now. And if you're new, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos.